संदीप घोष, ही इज एन ऑप-एड राइटर एंड अ कमेंटेटर. वी आर रशीद किदवाई, ऑथर ऑफ 24 अकबर रोड, एंड पी के डी नाम्बियार, अ कमेंटेटर एंड अ पोलिटिकल एनालिस्ट. नाम्बियार, फर्स्ट योर फर्स्ट थॉट्स ऑन वॉट दिस होल, यू नो, द टाइटल रादर, द कांग्रेसाइजेशन ऑफ बीजेपी. डू यू सी दैट हैपनिंग?
No, one is that,
and is it a derogatory or a praiseworthy comment?
Firstly, for a BJP sympathizer or the or any BJP karyakarta, it would be an derogatory statement. The reason being that BJP has always stood as a party with a difference. One, number two, it has got a cadre base and a very very ideologically connected. On the other hand, you ask, I mean, maybe you take that in the positive or in the negative. Some people say that it is Hindutva party, or some people say it's a nationalist party. So there is some kind of a narration and a brand, clean, clear brand identity for a BJP. And it's also known for its very, very strong cadre on the ground. So it may be some people who are coming from the RSS background, or even the people who are hardcore BJP guys. Now, the second part is that, yes, there is some kind of a change which is taking place in BJP, as the party has grown very, very fast. It's not an inorganic growth, sudden growth which took place in the last 10 years or so. Or that has definitely attracted a large number of people, like the congressmen coming in, or the people do not have any ideological base of whether it is an RSS or that matter too of BJP, or people who don't even know their ideological backup. They just came in, and that was something like accepted, like with an open arms. So there is some kind of a different class exists in BJP today, maybe a right way. But then the true BJP people, the people who have been a BJP karyakarta or a BJP leader for ages, they are different, whether it is in terms of their communication style, whether it is in terms of their functional style, and even the way their outlook about the country and to the common people, even including the development, is way different from the Congress. So Congress has never been, Congress was a culture. BJP is a different culture altogether. Congress do not have a specific character. BJP do have a strong character. So then congressmen, from some of the Congress leaders who say is that, yeah, we are not a party. We are more of like a leader and a group of people attached. So it's a collection of small, small groups is Congress. But whereas in the BJP, there is a structured or it's a very well structured organization from the booth to the national level to the parliamentary these things. And you keep seeing that there is a change. You can say Amit Shah may have a better hold on the party, but then there is JP Nadda, who is the president. So as the Venkaiya Naidu or the Rajnath Singh, the people and the leadership is keep changing. As Sandeep ji rightly said, there is no succession plan that junior Modi will come and take over. So there will be somebody else after a Modi will come. That is for sure in BJP. So from that
Rashid point is of laughing view, because Yogi is known as a junior Modi.
No, but
no comment.
But no.
Points like how there is a new BJP at play, but is there also a new Congress at play? You know, I like you to take that point. You know, we've seen this whole influx of outsiders coming in, given weighty positions. How does that measure with the rest of the Congress leaders?
See, firstly, I'll tell you that there is nothing called as new and old, because there is something
that's
called
journalist
as
shortcuts,
evolvement.
But they work.
No, Priyaji, it's basically called as evolvement. Now, you have changed, so am I. So as we all progress with the time, and politics is all about the timing. The time which maybe 10 years or 15 years, so that time is not the today's India. So India as a country has progressed, so as the politicians and so as the politics. So the idea is that today, if you offer something of that old mantras of Garibi, Atao and etc. may not really work today. Today, even if you, I speak to a large number of MPs and MLAs, even if they don't talk about Bijli Pani Sadak, the mantras of today's politics is changing. So the one is that BJP understood it pretty much faster, maybe because of Mr. Modi, and he was known to the governance, maybe with his experience in the Gujarat. So they have transformed themselves as a party with action, a party with values. While remaining with the values, they also become a party of an action. On the other side, the Congress, what happened was it has got legacy issues. It has got leadership issues, and it also had leadership issues not only just at the center, also in every state. So it was basically the younger generation and the older generation was not really able to get along, or the older generation was not really able to leave the power and get them to be on a retirement position. So there was a crisis of Congress as sort, and these crises has used as an opportunity by BJP. So that is the reason that you will find that typically different. For an example, in UP, once or twice, or maybe in the last 3 months, you must have seen that Priyanka Gandhi going to UP only from the last two or three times. It is more of like a Twitter or a just for the media. There is something I am also here in the fray. But whereas in the case of BJP, they have got prabharis and in charge, the ministerial in charge, organization in charge. Everybody is out on the street working for a victory. So I feel that BJP is a party which is having a hunger to work amongst the people. It is not just for the power, as an organization also to work. One of the senior most leader of a BJP a few days ago I met, I asked him that, why are you not getting into electoral politics? He said, yaar, kisko kya karna hai? क्या एमपी बनकर पांच साल रहेगा, क्या फायदा है? हमें नहीं करना, हमें राजनीति करना है। राजनीति होता है जनता के बीच में, मजा आता है। तो जिंदगी में सिर्फ पांच साल का कुर्सी से क्या होगा? चार
जगह। I think that's a very individual person.
I'm saying that even if the today
more like Rahul Gandhi than a BJP MP.
I'm saying that even if there are some people, some element is still there in BJP, it's a big. That's also because of a character that party is still able to maintain. Yes, I would say that there is, it's not like that the old BJP that are cutter, ideological, lead driven. That is not any party today. Even the CPIM, the communist parties are not like that. But yes, even if it is diluted, it is very, very less diluted as compared to anybody else. If you have Rashid, a second more, I can tell you something more.
No, I'll get you back in again. Rashid, that's a good comparison, actually, the corporate analogy. Nanma, you wanted to say something and also take up the Congress point of view?
So I agree with Sandeep ji completely that the Congress problem is a primarily a leadership crisis, not only at the center and again on each state. In fact, yesterday you would be surprised that some of the congressmen, the very hardcore congressmen from my home state, that is in Kerala, the organizational general secretary of the Congress has left and joined the CPIM. Can you imagine that? It is like an arch reverse. Like an organizational general secretary of Congress joining CPIM is something like ever unheard of. So that means there is in business, whether it is in business or in politics, it's all about aspirational management. Everybody comes with a lot of aspiration. Today, everybody wanted to become a chief minister or a party president or an MP, MLA. That is something very natural. If somebody who is working on the ground, really working hard, or somebody who has got a lot of money, or somebody who feels that I can speak well, or somebody who goes to a television debate feels that I am absolutely ready for a Rajya Sabha seat at least. So these are aspirations. So you need to have the role of the leadership is to manage that aspiration of these people. So both Rahul Gandhi and the Congress leadership on the center today is not at all able to even understand what is this aspiration management. How would they be able to? Another analogy about the Congress, the difference between a Congress and BJP, if you really look at it. BJP is a rich party. Of course, it is a large party. It's a ruling party, but it is a very rich party. Congress is not as rich as BJP. But then the difference is that all the Congress leaders are very, very, very rich, filthy rich. But whereas on the other side, you will not find the BJP leaders are not at all rich. They still remain in the same bracket or in the little upper and here and there. So the difference is that one is a party who is creating rich people and rich leaders or like a Jamindars or kings or queens on different places. On the other side, it is creating leaders who are supposed to come and work and do their role. And there is no permanent seat. The beauty is that all these changes, leadership changes, if you really look at it, the heavy weights like Yadiyurappa has been asked to go, that clearly sends a message that, man, sorry, there is no permanent place in BJP. You are a karyakarta. At the end of, you have been given a position by the party, and the party may ask you to vacate that position at any point of time. Now, it is for a political party or an organization to decide how to win an election. Is winning an election and giving that governance what it wants, not the chief minister wants. So the change is definitely is already there. It may be a very, very good business model if it is effectively implemented.
I've got to cut you because we're totally out of time. Otherwise, I have to cut the thing. But thank you all. And the Yedurappa test and the Rupani test, will it be work with Yogi? That is the test, because it's okay to remove a chief minister, but to remove a very popular chief minister, can they do that? That would be the real test of the center versus state strength in BJP terms alone. But thank you all for this discussion. And we'll see you all again same time next week.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.